हेलो।
हेलो।
हाँ दादा, अनम्यूट हो
हाँ, गुड
गया।
आफ्टरनून दानवे सर। दानवे सर, बैकग्राउंड में आवाज आए तुमसे।
वन मिनट। शुरू।
हेलो।
हाँ दादा,
यस यस। सो इंट्रोडक्शन,
हेलो। टुडे स्पीकर इज डॉक्टर विष्णु बावने। ही इज कंप्लीटेड हिज बीएमएस फ्रॉम एमएएचएस यूनिवर्सिटी, एमडी फ्रॉम मुंबई यूनिवर्सिटी। Now he is doing PhD from DY Patil School of Ayurveda and Hospital, PGDCR from DY Patil. He is MCIM member, that is, is also organizing secretary of World Ayush Expo. He is convener of National Teachers Forum, National Integrated Medical Association. Now he is working in DY Patil School of Ayurveda and Hospital as a associate professor in Prasuti Tantra and Stroke Department. Thank you.
So I, Dr. Girish Daga, welcome you all. I welcome Dr. Vishnu Bhavne sir. And in this NEMA's webinar, this is the second lecture. Before this, on last Sunday, we have organized one lecture on legal cell, that is laws in medical practice. And now today's it's the first lecture of from the Infertility Society. And this lecture, our speaker is Dr. Vishnu Bhavne. I request Dr. Vishnu Bhavne, please continue with his lecture. Dr. Vishnu Bhavne, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you. First of all, I bow down to Lord Dhanvantari, and before I start my lecture, at the outset, I would like to thanks and appreciate the Fertility Society, NEMA PC, NEMA MSB, for arranging such a nice lecture series. I think this is the second lecture of that series. Particularly, I would like to thank Dr. Gajanan Dhadve sir for the nice introduction of mine, and Dr. Girish Daga sir, Alok Gupta sir, and all the participants, my colleagues, friends, and respected seniors. If before starting my lecture, if there would be any disturbance or you would not be able to hear me properly, you can drop message in the chat box so that I would come to know that you are not able to hear me properly. Okay. So today's topic is integrated approach to PCOD. You all know what is PCOD. PCOD, the full form of PCOD is polycystic ovarian disease. It is also known as PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome. Most of the times, PCOS and PCOD are used as synonyms also. The difference between PCOD and PCOS is PCOS is a disease, and when the all symptom complex, any syndrome is a symptom complex. PCOS is nothing but it's a symptom complex, like irregular menses, obesity. We are going to discuss thoroughly as we proceed. So let's understand what is PCOD or PCOS. PCOS is one of the leading causes of infertility in women. PCOS is a condition where hormonal imbalance affects follicular growth during the ovarian cycle, causing the affected follicles to remain in the ovary. The retained follicle forms a cyst. With each ovarian cycle, a new cyst is formed, leading to the multiple ovarian cycle or multiple ovarian cyst. It is nothing but a folliculogenesis is arrested. And in every normal ovarian cycle, there is a normal growth of, sir, next slide please. There is a normal growth of follicle. If you look at this slide, in the normal ovary, what happens? The primordial follicles, they are converted into primary follicles and secondary follicles, mature follicles, and ovulation takes place, average on the 14th day of period. This is the normal cycle, the normal ovarian cycle. If after the ovulation, if patient conceives, the pregnancy continues, and the corpus luteum produces the progesterone, and the pregnancy continues. If patient fails to conceive, then it remains. Then the corpus luteum is converted into corpus albicans. Alba means white. It remains as a white dot on the ovary. This is a normal ovary. This normal ovarian cycle takes place in the ovary. But in PCOS, what happens? The complete development of the follicle is arrested. You can see here, the development is arrested. I cannot highlight. You can see the multiple immature follicles. And these immature follicles, they fail to grow further. And their maturation is arrested. There is one message. Am I audible?
Yeah.
Okay. So there was one message in the chat box regarding the volume. Okay. So this is the difference between a knock. I request the host, Dr. Dhadve sir and Girish Daga sir, please unmute yourself while speaking on phone. We're discussing about the normal ovary and polycystic ovaries. Poly means multiple. Cystic, a cyst, a fluid filled structure. It is known as a cyst. So this is a very basic difference between a normal ovary and a polycystic ovary. Simply, the maturation is arrested. Next slide, please, sir. Girish, sir.
Girish, hello, sir, next Girish. Slide, please. Girish.
Okay. You can see very clearly the difference between a polycystic. A multiple cysts are formed in the ovaries. Sir, next slide. Girish, sir, next slide, please. See, here you can also you can see the difference between normal menstrual cycle and a cycle of a PCOS female. There is a difference between a cycle. These are the cycle days. This yellow, if you can see the yellow lining. This is a slide, please. So, it was in the graphical structure, it is shown that in the normal menstrual cycle, the FSH and LH, there is a curve is shown. But in the PCOS cycle, the LH and FSH ratio is completely disrupted, which causes a PCOS. Girish sir, please, can you share the slide? By the time we share, I'll proceed. First time, PCOD was first described in 1935 by Stein and Leventhal as PCOS is a syndrome manifested by amenorrhea, hirsutism, and obesity. Majorly amenorrhea, hirsutism, and obesity associated with enlarged polycystic ovaries. Girish sir, can you please?
Hello, Girish.
Oh, sir, just
start the PPT. PPT is not visible on the screen. Girish sir, please share the PPT on the screen.
Yes, sir, just a minute.
Okay. So it was first described in 1935 by this Stein Leventhal. It's a syndrome. The major symptoms are amenorrhea, hirsutism, and obesity associated with enlarged polycystic ovaries. It's a heterogeneous disorder characterized by the excess androgen production by the ovaries that interferes with the reproductive, endocrine, and metabolic function. Because majorly in the female body is not supposed to do hard work, muscular work. That's why if female indulges themselves in the muscular work, it results in the excess androgens. Androgens are produced along with the estrogens and hello.
Just a minute.
Along with, can you share PPT, sir? Even three participants, they are saying that I am not audible. The controlling of PPT is with Girish sir. That's why I am not able to share the PPT. Hello. Okay, thank you, sir. We were discussing about the definition.
The next slide or this slide? This one or next one?
Yes, sir. Next one. Next yes, one. Sir. Yeah, this one.
Sorry okay. for interruption, sir.
No issue, sir.
Yeah.
I was discussing about the definition, which is laid down by the Stein Leventhal in 1935. You all know that the definitions are very critical. PCOS, mainly we had already discussed this, that it is manifested by the amenorrhea, hirsutism, and obesity. And the disorder is characterized by the excess androgen productions by the ovaries that interferes with the reproductive, endocrine, and metabolic functions. Next slide, sir.
Yes. Sir, if you can please keep your mic little bit closer, some audio issues are still there.
Okay.
Yeah, next slide.
Hello. Sir. Please check mic. Am I audible now?
Yeah.
It's audible. Little voice is little less, sir. Not that much audible.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Okay, continue, sir.
Now, if you look at the prevalence rate, the global prevalence rate is 2.2% to 26%. Roughly, in every 15 women worldwide, there is one patient suffering from PCOS. And nowadays, this ratio, this prevalence rate is increasing day by day due to the sedentary lifestyles and lack of exercise and dietary habits. If you look at the global the prevalence rate in India, 36% of women are suffering from PCOS in India. Next slide, sir. We recently discussed about the incidence rate, prevalence rate. Why to worry? Why this incidence rate is worrying us? Because the most common endocrine disorder affecting 5 to 10% women of reproductive age. Reproductive age, it is ranging between the 15 to 45 years of age. That is the reproductive age. Incidence is increasing fast with change in lifestyle and stress, because nowadays the life is very stressful. Most of the women, they are doing jobs. So in particularly in metropolitan cities, the stress is increasing. And the most frequent cause of infertility is PCOS in women. Strongly associated insulin resistance that creates risk for diabetes, cardiovascular disorder, and hypertension. These are the things which are really worrying. That's why this incidence rate is worrying, because ultimately PCOD is not only hampering the affecting the fertility, but also the insulin resistance, diabetes, cardiovascular disorder. This PCOD is responsible for these disorders, comorbid conditions. So that's why this disease is very important, and really we need to worry about it. Next slide, sir. Causes like the modern medicine, sometimes if they found nothing, they said that the unknown etiology. It is very not clearly known yet. Research is going on, maybe, but few identified causes, like maybe change in lifestyle, diet, and stress. Genetic factors, if we talk about the genetic factor, the CYP21 gene mutation is responsible. The family history is there. Obesity causing insulin resistance and hyperinsulinemia. These are some possible causes mentioned about PCOD. I will not go in the details. Next slide.
Issues are still there. I think you have to hold your mic little bit closer.
Okay, I change my just wait, sir. Wait.
Yes.
Sorry for inconvenience.
No issues. So for audience, I will again repeat the tomorrow session. Tomorrow session will be of Dr. Utane sir.
Hello.
Hello. Hi. Yes, sir.
Yeah. You are audible.
Now audible, sir?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Clearly. Now it's clear. Good.
Very good.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Very good.
Thank you. Thanks. Sorry for the disturbance.
No issue. Continue.
Okay. So this is a simple the diagram here that describing about the hormonal, the HPO axis, the whole this cycle, this mechanism, the cycle, the ovaries, these are controlled by the axis is there, HPO axis, hypothalamo pituitary ovarian axis, which regulates the menstruation and hormones in a female body. Next slide, sir. Nine dirty foods that cause PCOS. As far as possible, try to avoid these foods. First and foremost is dairy products. Most of the female, they indulge themselves in consuming the dairy products, milk and the byproducts of the milk. Most of the milk protein, most of the patient, they are allergic to the milk proteins or the milk products. So it creates a lot of digestive problems or allergic reactions. So this is one important cause. If you discuss the second cause, white sugar, it increases the sugar levels. Insulin resistance is there. The condition is like a diabetes mellitus. That's why the white sugar, if the PCOD is present in the families, try to avoid the white sugar. Then white flour and white rice. The glycemic index is more. That's why the most nowadays with the physicians they advise to consume the whole wheat flour rather than the white flour. It is advisable. It affects the digestive system. Then the gluten grains. The gluten is present in the barley and the wheat. It may interferes with the digestive problems. So try to avoid it. It is one of the cause of PCOS. Then the red meat. It affects your hormonal system. Next one is alcohol. In the Western countries and now in India also, the alcohol consumption, it worsens the metabolism of the sugar. Then hydrogenated oils. It raises the bad cholesterol and lowers the good cholesterol. The bad cholesterol is LDL. LDL is a bad cholesterol. And the good cholesterol is HDL. It interferes with the cholesterol, the good cholesterol. That's why it is one of the cause. Then the caffeine increase estrogen levels and affects the fertility. So the caffeine is very dangerous. It is very dangerous for the health. Then high glycemic index foods. It affects the sugar level, and as we already discussed that the insulin resistance is there. So this is one of the cause. So these are the 9 foods that causes PCOS. One is dairy products, second is white sugar, third one is white flour and rice, gluten grains, red meat, alcohol, hydrogenated oils, caffeine, and the foods having high glycemic index. Next slide, sir. Next slide, sir.
Yeah, it's attitude. Next slide or this one?
Next slide. I will not go into details of the modern pathophysiology. I will discuss in details in Ayurveda segment. Now, if you look at the symptoms, so first is the symptoms of ovulatory dysfunction. Which symptoms are produced due to ovulatory dysfunction? So the most important symptom is amenorrhea or oligomenorrhea. Amenorrhea means complete absence of menses or periods. Oligo means scanty menses. And it constitutes for 87% of causes. Second is irregular uterine bleeding. There is irregularity in the uterine bleeding and it constitutes 26%. Then the symptoms are then infertility. Infertility, it constitutes for the 20%. So these are the symptoms, these three symptoms, these are produced due to the ovulatory dysfunction. Amenorrhea, irregular uterine bleeding and infertility. Second, symptoms of androgen excess. Which symptoms we can observe? Like first is hirsutism. Hirsutism is hair growth, facial hair growth. Acne is it is due to the hyperandrogenism, due to the excess androgens. Then alopecia, the male pattern baldness or alopecia, hair fall is seen, and this is due to the androgen excess. These three symptoms are produced due to androgen excess: hirsutism, acne, and alopecia or male pattern baldness. Last one is symptoms of insulin resistance. Due to insulin resistance, acanthosis nigricans is produced. What is acanthosis nigricans? It is nothing but the blackish discoloration over the neck and the nape area. That is acanthosis, hyperkeratosis of the skin. That is nigricans. Nigra means the black. That is the blackish discoloration. That is acanthosis nigricans. And last one is obesity. Obesity and acanthosis nigricans, these symptoms are produced due to high insulin resistance. Next slide, sir. You can see all the symptoms over here in this pic. First, the thinning of hair. If you see the female like this, you can diagnose. It's very easy to diagnose PCOD. Thinning of hair, then presence of hair on the back, hair on the lip, chin, neck area, hair on the chest. Next symptom is acne, ovarian cyst, hair on the abdomen. PCOS causes the infertility, missed periods, then hidradenitis suppurativa. Means in the groins and armpits, the glands are enlarged. Nodules you can feel, that is the hidradenitis suppurativa. Then the dark discolored skins and spots are seen in the armpits and the groins also. Excess weight around the waist. So these are the symptoms. You can see all the symptoms in this one image. So next slide, please. We will see the each entity, each symptoms one by one. In the first diagram, you can see the acne. This is due to the hyperandrogen status. In the second image, there is a blackish discoloration over the neck and nape area. It is due to the hyperandrogens again. It's a blackish discoloration. You can easily observe that discoloration. In the third image, hirsutism, there is a facial hair growth. In the fourth one, obesity, irregular. In the second row, irregular menses. Then baldness, alopecia, and infertility. These are the clinical manifestations of PCOD. If you see these symptoms, you can easily diagnose the PCOD. Next slide, sir. Especially these three symptoms are produced by the excess androgens: hirsutism, acne, and baldness. Most of the times, what happens when patient of PCOD comes to our OPD, when his patient approaches to our OPD, sometimes the manifestations are different. Patients comes with acne only, so we treat the we advise the treatment for acne only. Sometimes patients present with the hirsutism, we advise the patient to go for the hair removal or the hair removal with the lasers or others. Baldness, we treat the baldness only, but here we forget to ask the detailed history. We miss out the diagnosis, the root cause of this hirsutism, acne, baldness, even the obesity. We treat all these symptoms or diseases separately, and we try to diagnose the PCOD. And if we fail to diagnose the PCOD at the right time, and these symptoms gets more, even more worse. So whenever patient comes to your OPD, a female patient especially, the childbearing age, comes to your OPD and complaining of the hirsutism, acne, baldness, obesity, or irregular periods, ask detailed history, because the detailed history taking is very important. Otherwise, you may miss the diagnosis. At general practitioner level, we usually treat the single entity disease, and we may miss out this diagnosis. I will just give you a simple mnemonics of this disease. 3F. You can remember 3F: face, figure, and fertility. Face, the face is distorted. Face is distorted with the hirsutism and acne. Then face, figure due to the excess weight, obesity, the figure is distorted. And third one is fertility. This presence of 3F is very important in PCOD. If patient is unmarried patient of PCOD, then face and figure matters the most for unmarried patient. It matters for the married patient also, but especially the face and figure matters the most for unmarried PCOD patients. And if patient is married, for the married PCOD patients, fertility matters the most comparatively with the face and figure. So you can remember, you can easily remember or diagnose this. You can see the 3F. You can with the 3Fs, you can easily remember the disease, and it would be easy to for the diagnosis also. Next slide. Acanthosis nigricans. These are the symptoms of insulin resistance. Why this blackish discoloration is there? It is due to the blackish pigmentation is there due to the excess, due to the insulin resistance. You can see over the neck and nape area. Clearly visible symptoms. It would be easy to diagnose the PCOD. Next slide, sir. Now we will just take a revision what we learned today. Understanding PCOD. These are the signs and symptoms. We'll start with head. At head, dandruff, male pattern baldness, depression. It is seen in this head area. If you consider the face, excessive hair growth, and the coarse hair growth. Coarse means the rough hairs. Masculine features are seen on the face. Skin, especially the dark patches, and the cystic acne. The acne is can't hear, not audible. Am I audible?
Yes, clearly, yeah. Loudly.
Okay, then in the chat box, someone has posted that, sir.
No, it's clear.
Okay. So then the abdomen, if you look at the abdominal area, weight gain is there. And in the pelvis, thickening of the wall of uterus. Why there is thickening of wall of uterus? Patient missed the period. So patient fails to shed that endometrium, that endometrium every month, patient due to amenorrhea. So there is a thickening of uterine walls. Polycystic ovaries, multiple cysts are seen. Irregular menses or amenorrhea, then infertility. This is seen in the pelvic area. Now the causes, the GnRH, the gonadotropin releasing hormone, it is secreted from the hypothalamus, it is increased. Then LH and FE FSH ratio, it is it is disrupted, then even the insulin resistance is there, so the levels of insulin in the blood increases, which causes the weight gain, skin changes, and fungal infection. Like in diabetes, even the fungal infection is more common because insulin resistance is there in the diabetes. Similarly, the fungal infection and the skin changes happens in these cases. And the due to excess testosterone, acne, facial hair, and the masculine features. So that's it. So next slide, sir. To just revise the what we learned. Now, when to say PCOS? There are so many clinical symptoms are present. We just discuss and saw that the symptoms are visible. But still, what is the when to say that it is a PCOS? The Rotterdam criteria should be used to diagnose the PCOS. So what is Rotterdam's diagnostic criteria? If two of the three following criteria are present, then only we can say that patient is suffering from PCOS. The first criteria is polycystic ovaries, either 12 or more peripherally arranged follicles of 2 to 9 mm in diameter, or increased ovarian volume greater than 10 cubic centimeter. So first criteria is either there are 12 or more peripherally arranged small follicles of which size 2 to 9 mm of in diameter, or increase ovarian volume of greater than 10 cubic centimeter. The ovarian volume is increased. Second is oligo or unovulation. Oligo means less or un, that is the complete absence of ovulation. And third one is the signs of hyperandrogenism, excess male hormones. So if two of the three following criteria are present, we can see PCOS. Suppose if a patient comes with the polycystic with the sonography with the report of ultrasound showing the polycystic ovary and complaining of the in the oligo or we can in the follicle study also oligo or unovulation is seen, then we can say that according to Rotterdam criteria, it is the case of PCOS, or oligo or unovulation and the signs of hyperandrogenism. You can combine any two symptoms of these three symptoms, then we can say that patient is a case of polycystic ovarian syndrome. Next slide, sir. Now, after this Rotterdam criteria, the classification of criteria, the PCOS is done in the major criteria and minor criteria. The major criteria includes unovulation, oligomenorrhea, spelling mistake is there, oligomenorrhea, hyperandrogenemia, severe hirsutism, insulin resistance. If any one of the symptoms is present, it falls under the major criteria. The first one is unovulation, second is oligomenorrhea, third one is hyperandrogenemia, third one is severe hirsutism, and the fourth one is insulin resistance. In the minor criteria, polycystic ovaries on ultrasound, second is elevated LH to FSH ratio, the LH luteinizing hormone to and FSH is follicle stimulating hormone. The ratio is disrupted. The ratio of LH and FSH is disrupted. It becomes 3:1 most of the times. The acne. Next is acne and mild hirsutism and obesity. Just go through this major and minor criteria. Depends on this classification. The next slides we are going to discuss. With the further discussion is based on this slide. That's why just go through this major and minor criteria once again. The minor criteria, polycystic ovaries. Second is elevated LH to FSH ratio, acne, mild hirsutism, and obesity. Next slide, sir. Now, based on that major and minor criteria, you can define the mild, moderate, and severe form of PCOS. If there is a presence of one minor criteria, then you can say that there is a tendency of PCOS in that patient. Presence of two minor criteria, what it suggests, that is the mild form of PCOS. Then presence of one major and one minor criteria, that is moderate form of PCOS, and presence of one or more major and two or more major criteria, minor criteria, it suggests the severe form of PCOS. You can diagnose the tendency mild, moderate, and severe form of PCOS based on the major and minor criteria. So in severe form of PCOS, one or more major and two or more minor criteria is present. Next slide, sir. Now, how to differentiate? Most of the times you may get confused with the PCOS. So differential diagnosis is very important while diagnosing any disease. The differential diagnosis of hirsutism and oligomenorrhea includes the congenital adrenal hyperplasia. The congenital adrenal hyperplasia, the symptoms may resemble with the PCOS. Second is Cushing's syndrome. The buffalo hump and the Blackie's discoloration is present in the Cushing's syndrome. And the hyperthecosis ovary. In the hyperthecosis ovary, what happens? The lining of the ovaries, it becomes thickened and they start producing the male hormones. They start producing the androgens. So that is the hyperthecosis ovary. Hyperthecosis means this thickening of the ovarian lining. Then the benign and malignant androgen secreting tumors or ovaries. So these are the entities which you can use for the differential diagnosis of PCOS. Next slide. Now, investigations part. Investigation. Our Indian doctors actually are known worldwide for the clinical diagnosis. But nowadays, we rely too much on the laboratory investigations or radiological and sonological investigations. So before advising investigations, history and physical examination is very important. That's why I mentioned this point in the investigation, because it is very important before advising the laboratory investigations. What are the investigations which are advised to diagnose PCOD or PCOS at a laboratory level? LH and FSH ratio, E2, estradiol, then testosterone, androstenedione, SHBG, sex hormone binding globulin, 17-hydroxyprogesterone, 17-OHP, DHEAS, prolactin, TSH, T3, T4, and the fasting insulin level. Then FBS, fasting blood sugar, total cholesterol, the cholesterol, LDL and HDL ratio. These are important because to diagnose, because in PCOS, the cholesterol level is disrupted. Dyslipidemia is there. So you need to get these investigations done, LDL and HDL also. Then the pelvic ultrasound, which is commonly advised investigation to detect the PCOS. Most of the times we detect detect the PCOD with normal ultrasound only, or in few cases we advise the TVS. transvaginal sonography is required. So, and the next specific imaging procedure to exclude adrenal tumors if presentation is rapid, if required. But the basic investigations include these investigations mentioned on this slide. First, you can go for the pelvic ultrasound and the hormonal investigations along with the insulin, FBS, prolactin, and T3, T4, TSH. So these are the investigations to be advised to rule out the PCOS. Next slide. In the incidence, we saw that there is a reason to worry if patient is suffering from the severe form of PCOS, because the long-term risk is involved with this, it is responsible for the diabetes, heart disease, hypertension, dyslipidemia, endometrial cancer, breast cancer, recurrent pregnancy loss. Even if patient conceives, there is a recurrent pregnancy loss, ovarian failure after surgery. So these are the long-term risk involved in the patients of PCOS. Next slide, sir. Now the treatment part. We are very much interested in this treatment part. Most of the time we ignore the diagnosis, but frankly speaking, diagnosis is very important. Treatment is, most of the practitioners, treatment part is important, but treatment, you can give the treatment after proper diagnosis. The proper diagnosis is important. Without diagnosing a proper disease, the treatment advice by just merely watching or advising the treatment, it fails, because proper diagnosis is important. So I'm not, this is more than 2000 patients of PCOD and PCOS with Ayurvedic treatment only. So as to avoid the modern medicine, I completely stopped their modern medicine when I start the treatment, because if we are getting the results with Ayurvedic medicine and Panchakarma, then if these facilities are available with you, you can go for this treatment, because unnecessarily bombarding with this modern treatment, it may cause lot of risk to the patient. I'm not going into the details of the modern treatment. I'll just highlight the which treatment options are available. The first step is to help the patient understand the chronic disease process and changes in the lifestyle. So counseling is very important. Nowadays, counseling is very important part. You can educate the patient. You can make aware the patient with the chronicity of the disease and the risk involved. And you can ask the patient to make certain changes in the lifestyle. Nowadays, you all are aware that we are facing a pandemic, world pandemic situation, COVID-19. So no specific treatment is available. So only the dinacharya, rutucharya, and the lifestyle modification is advised, and the other hygiene, it is the stress. We are stressing on the respiratory and high hygiene, and then hand hygiene. So these are our basics. So we should focus on the basic lifestyle modification to treat the disease. Then, next slide. Metformin. Insulin resistance is there. So metformin is prescribe along with the lifestyle modification. It gives better results. Then the clomiphene citrate. It induces the ovulation. Ovulation inducing drug clomiphene is citrate. Clomiphene citrate is started as a first line method of medical ovulation in the anovulatory women. If required, then only start the medicine. Then the second line treatment is laparoscopic ovarian drilling. Laparoscopically, the ovarian drilling is done and the use of gonadotropin therapy. Next slide. Adrenal suppression is done with the dexamethasone to facilitate the ovulation. Anti-androgens, the ciproterone acetate and the ethyl estradiol in combination is given given as an anti-androgens. Then the spironolactone, which is diuretic, it is given alternative to anti-androgens. And the low dose of oral contraceptive, but I will not recommend these medicines. This patient feels better. If patients, they are worried that they are not getting periods for the 2 to 3 months, so they prefer to go for to take this contraceptive. His patient feels better that she gets menstruation regularly, but in long term, the oral contraceptives are harmful. Next slide. Next slide. We already discussed this point. Next slide. So I feel that PCOD is a metabolic syndrome with reproductive implications and the huge impact on the reproductive, metabolic, and the cardiovascular health of affected girls and women. So we can see that the womanhood is this is disturbed. It's a thief of womanhood. You can another use as synonyms to the PCOD. There is a thief of womanhood. Next slide. Now, the Ayurvedic management and the Ayurvedic views regarding the PCOS. We are running short of time, so I will try to. Next slide, sir. So the PCOD management with Ayurveda involves the Ayurvedic medications, Ayurvedic Panchakarma, diet modification, lifestyle modification. This is the pyramid. It is showing the management of holistic management of PCOD with Ayurveda. Next slide, please. What is the concept of Ayurveda? Actually, the PCOD is not mentioned in the Ayurveda, but the similar symptoms, but there is no need to directly correlate PCOD with the other entities, but the few symptoms or the few diseases they mention whose symptoms are similar to the PCOS, like in the Kashyap Samhita also the Prutha Loma Gandasha means the Loma Gandasha means the facial hair growth. It is mentioned in the Kashyap Samhita also. Even in the Charak Yuniyapadana Adhyaya Rajaska, the symptoms resembles with the symptoms of the modern disease PCOD or PCOS. So according to Ayurveda, the Strotorodha Janya Grathita Bija Kosh. Strotorodha means the obstructions in the system. Grathita, cyst or multiple cyst are formed. Granthi means the Grathit means the cyst. And the Bija Kosh. Bija kosh is ovary. So, Strotorodha Janya Grathita Bija kosh. Ayurveda sees towards this disease as a Strotorodha Janya Grathita Bija kosh. Next slide, please. Then, Hetu the Santarpan Janya. This disorder is mainly there is a vata and kapha predominance is there. So mainly the santarpan janya, these are the hetu or causative agents. Fatty, sweet, heavy diet, the consumption of fatty, sweet and heavy diet, then the consumption of alcohol, fast foods, non-veg, high carbohydrate foods, and the lack of exercise, diva swap, daytime sleep, diva swap. These are the hetus, major hetus of PCOS. Next slide, please. Pathogenesis, samprapti, rasa dhatuagni mande is there. So, roga sarva, you all know that roga sarvapi mandagni, the agni is very important. In this condition, agni mande is there, especially rasa dhatuagni mande is there, and along with the rasa dhatuagni mande, medo dhatuagni mande is there, then stroto orod is there, meda sanche. Then reduction in the agni causes the cyst formation and imbalance of hormones, reduction in the FSH and increased LH ratio. There is then the hormones are completely, there is a imbalance in the hormones also, and it causes the unovulation. So Ayurveda sees majorly Ayurveda, according to Ayurveda, rasa dhatvagni, medo dhatvagni mandya and strotorod and meda sanchay is there. So agni is very important. Agni rakshan is very important according to Ayurveda to manage this disorder. Next slide, please. Next slide. Kapha dosha is cold and dense. With its heavy, cool qualities, it nourishes the development of the tissues that form and support the reproductive system. This also supports the growth of the follicle during the ovarian cycles. PCOS occurs when kapha blocks the other two doshas. When the kapha blocks the other two doshas, vata and pitta, thus the movement of the mature ovum and the menstrual blood is obstructed. So there will be obstructions. There will be obstruction in the menstrual blood and the ovum. That is due to the sticky cuff and the transformation process is suppressed. We had already the pathophysiology is the same. Then due to strotorod, maturation fails. The arrest of follicle is there. Next slide. Next slide.
Is hormonal disharmony or next?
Sir, next slide, please. Okay. So, dosha involved in PCOD. Vata predominance is there. Which are the symptoms of vata predominance? Associated with the menstrual pain, menstrual irregularity, low weight, and coldness. If the pitta, which are the symptoms which dominates, which are pitta predominant, hair loss, painful menses, acne, clots, and the heart problem. The spelling mistake is there. Kapha predominance, increased weight, infertility, facial hairs, diabetic tendencies, and coldness. These are the symptoms due to the vata, pitta, and the kapha dominance. Next slide, please. The treatment principles involve the normalize the metabolism, that is the correction of agni. Correction of agni is very important. Cleansing of bowel, basti. Then regulate the artava, reducing the circulating androgens and optimizing the ovarian function and supporting optimal endocrine functions. These are the treatment principles which needs to follow to treat PCOD successfully. Next slide, sir. Next slide. Aur kitna samay hai mere liye?
Samay ka koi limit nahi.
Okay. So, I'll directly go to Chikitsa Sutra. Panchakarma, in Panchakarma, Vaman, in Panchakarma, Virechan, Basti, Uttar Basti, and Nasya. These are very useful processes. Virechan, विरेचन, अनुलोमन, दीज आर दिस पंचकर्म प्रोसेस आर रिक्वायर्ड. बस्ती नहीं वाता द्रुत योनाम नारीनाम संप्रदश्यते. वात दुष्टि इज देयर इन एनी युनिवापदाज. सो बस्ती इज द बेस्ट ट्रीटमेंट फॉर द पीसीओडी और एनी फीमेल डिसऑर्डर. अगर आपको कुछ नहीं समझा तो मैं इसलिए बोलता हूँ कि अगर कुछ नहीं समझा तो कम से कम ईच एंड एवरी फीमेल पेशेंट में कोई भी डिसऑर्डर हो उसमें आप बस्ती इज वेरी यूजफुल ट्रीटमेंट, बिकॉज वात के लिए सर्वश्रेष्ठ चिकित्सा बस्ती है. एंड जो यूटरस है वो अपान के क्षेत्र में है, इट इज इन द रीजन ऑफ अपाना. सो बस्ती इज द बेस्ट ट्रीटमेंट. देन उत्तर बस्ती, इवन द उत्तर बस्ती कैन बी यूज एज अ क्षेत्र चिकित्सा इन मैरिड पेशेंट, मैरिड पीसीओडी पेशेंट ओनली. नस्य डायरेक्टली एक्ट्स ऑन द एचपीओ एक्सिस, हाइपोथैलेमो पिट्यूटरी ओवेरियन एक्सिस. इट इज एब्जॉर्ब फ्रॉम द क्रिब्रिफॉर्म प्लेक्सस एंड इट गिव्स द गुड रिजल्ट. I have tried on the many patients of secondary amenorrhea. Most of the times for secondary amenorrhea we give withdrawal bleeding, but instead of giving withdrawal bleeding, adrak swaras nasya gives better results because it is ushna and tikshna in nature. Adrak swaras nasya, two drops each nostrils for 3 days, it stimulates the HPO axis and patient gets periods in the 5 to 6 days along with the other medicines. But nasya is very useful especially to treat the secondary amenorrhea in the patients of PCOS. Then the vatagna and kafagna aushadhi. Why vatagna and kafagna? Majorly the vata and kapha predominance is there. Next slide. Rasa dhatu पाचन. रस धातु अग्निमानदे इज देयर, सो रस धातु पाचन इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. रस पाचक योग इज अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट ऑल्सो. देन रजोशोधन इज द शोधन ऑफ रजा इज इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इट इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड. मेदोपाचक ड्रग्स आर यूज. वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मेडिसिन्स. Then the kleda shoshan, kleda like diabetes in PCOD also the kleda formation is there. So kleda shoshak medicines are very much useful to treat the PCOD successfully. Vatanuloman with this simple gandharva hrit ki churna or erand shunti yukta erand tail, it is important. Then kapha shodhan and shaman. This is the chikitsa sutra. It is very important. Someone has encircled it. It is very important part in my lecture, I think. Next slide. Can you erase this from the screen? Yes, thank you. Now our practitioners and students are very much interested in the formulations, so I will discuss the formulation. But I have not mentioned the dose because the dose, the matra, you have to decide the matra according to the prakruti, dosha, dushya, dushti, vyadibal. So I have not mentioned because I don't want to just copy paste the matra or the dose of the drugs. So I'll just discuss the which drugs are important. First is Asava Arishta Kumari Asav. Kumari Asav is very useful. Dashamula Arishta. Dashmul is Vatashamak. So Dashmula Arishta is useful. Ashoka Arishta. Ashoka is also known as the Stri Mitra. It is a friend of females. So Ashoka Arishta. Karpas Mulaso. Karpas Mulaso acts on the uterus. Karpas Mulaso and Devadarva Arishta acts on the They act as a uterine tonic. They act on the uterine muscles. So these two drugs are very useful. Then paripathadi kada. In vatiguti, tapyadi lohavati, कांचनार गुगुल चंद्रप्रभावटी आरोग्यवर्धिनी वटी पुष्प धनवारस लघुमालिनी वसंत योगराज गुगुल कुबेराक्ष वटी एंड शरपुंखा घनवटी. इफ यू लुक एट द चूर्ण शतावरी शतावरी कंटेन्स द फाइटोइस्ट्रोजेंस गुडुची शरपुंखा शतपुष्पा शतावरी सारिवा एंड सारिवा प्लस मंजिष्ठा सारिवा एंड मंजिष्ठा रक्त प्रसादन ड्रग्स तील गुड एंड भारंगी तील एंड गुड अगेन तील एंड गुड इज ऑल्सो अ वेरी गुड मेडिसिन आई यूज आई रूटीनली प्रिस्क्राइब इन माय प्रैक्टिस तील कृष्ण तील स्पेशली द कृष्ण तील एंड गुड इफ पेशेंट फेस टू मेस्ट्रुएट इन द स्पेशली इन द सेकेंडरी अमेनोरिया द तील एंड गुड कृष्ण तील एंड गुड भरड इज मेड एंड इक्वल क्वांटिटी में उसको लेकर उसका काढ़ा बनाकर अगर सुबह देंगे तो इट इज वेरी मच यूजफुल कृष्ण तिल स्पेशली. देन गंधर्व हरितकी एंड हिंगवाष्टक चूर्ण गंधर्व हरितकी इज यूज फॉर अनुलोमन एंड हिंगवाष्टक चूर्ण इज यूज फॉर द दीपन एंड पाचन. नेक्स्ट कृष्ण तिल के बारे में एक आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर वन स्टोरी. एक पेशेंट थी उरन से आती थी डीवाई पाटिल में. सो हर एज वॉज अराउंड हर एज वॉज 70 ईयर्स. मेरे लाइफ में मैंने पहली पेशेंट देखी कि सी वॉज मेंस्ट्रुएटिंग नॉर्मली एट द एज ऑफ 70 एंड सी वॉज वर्किंग एज अ स्टाफ नर्स. सो आफ्टर तिल संक्रांत जो रहता है मकर संक्रांत 14 तब वो आई थी अराउंड. तो सी वॉज बिफोर दैट सी वॉज मेंस्ट्रुएटिंग नॉर्मली एंड सी केम विद द कंप्लेंट दैट सडनली सी स्टार्टेड हेवी ब्लीडिंग. सो आई आस्क सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस कि दही खा रही है अचार पापड़ ऐसा कुछ खा रही है क्या. तो मेरे ध्यान में आया कि सी वॉज कंज्यूमिंग कृष्ण सी वॉज कंज्यूमिंग द तिल तिल के लड्डू मकर संक्रांत. तो आई आस्क कि तिल के लड्डू खाए क्या बहुत ज्यादा. सो सी सेड यस. सो तिल इतना इफेक्टिव है कि सेकेंडरी अमेनोरिया में तिल और गुड़ का कॉट इज वेरी इफेक्टिव. नो नीड टू प्रिस्क्राइब द विड्रॉल ब्लीडिंग. सो तिल क्या कर सकते हो पेशेंट जैसे मैंने कुछ भी मेडिसिन नहीं दिया जस्ट आस्क टू स्टॉप ईटिंग द तिल का लड्डू फॉर फ्यू डेज एंड पेशेंट सेड कि पेशेंट का बाद में आए तो बोले कि बेटा कुछ मेडिसिन लेने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ी सब ठीक है. सो ये तिल इतना यूजफुल है. देन रज प्रवर्तनी वटी इज यूजफुल इन द सेकेंडरी अमेनोरिया. इट कंटेन्स द एलोवेरा कासिस टंकन एंड हिंग. एलोवेरा व्हाट एलोवेरा डज इट प्यूरिफाइज द ब्लड एंड स्टिमुलेट्स द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. रज प्रवर्तनी वटी इज यूज इन द सेकेंडरी अमेनोरिया. देन सुवर्ण माक्षिक भस्म इट बैलेंसेज द कफ एंड पित्त दोषा. इट्स मेन इनग्रीडियंट्स आर कॉपर एंड आयन पायराइट. फलघृत द नेम इटसेल्फ सजेस्ट फल प्राप्ति के लिए जो फलघृत है इट इज वेरी यूजफुल. आप ओरली भी दे सकते हो फलघृत ओरली भी कंज्यूम करने के लिए बोल सकते हो या फिर आप उत्तर बस्ती में भी फलघृत यूज होता है फॉर द क्षेत्र चिकित्सा. इट रिजुविनेट्स एंड इट्स अ फर्टिलिटी एनहांसर. घी कंटेन्स विटामिन ई and that's why vitamin E is anti-sterility vitamin. So again phalagrut the contents uske aise ki it's very useful. It's a fertility enhancer. Those who are not sometimes the ghee creates nausea and vomiting like symptom. So even it is available in the tablet form also. And next slide we are continuing with the formulation. Then the pushpa dhanvaras, it regulates the ovulation, strengthens the artavah strotas, and it's a rasayan. Tapyadi lohavati punarnava mandur it is useful in the for the rakta vruddhi and also punarnava mandur is useful for the lekhan. Kanchanar gugul is very useful in PCOD because it is indicated in the granthi apache means this any cystic here the disease itself, it is the multiple follicles are formed. So Kanchanar Gugul plays a very important role to reduce the cyst. Then Chandra Prabhavati contains Sila Jatu. It is used as a rasayan in most of the female disorder. Chandra Prabhavati is useful, especially in PCOD. It is very useful, Chandra Prabhavati. It contains Sila Jatu. Next. I'll need five minutes more. I'm going to. Then the Asavarista we had already discussed. Next. Arogya Vardini, the name itself suggests the Arogya Vardhan, the drugs which it helps to enhance your health. That is Arogya Vardini Vati is useful. It stimulates the liver. For liver, Arogya Vardhani is important because liver is very important organ in the metabolism. So Arogya Vardhani Vati can be given for the 45 days. Lagumalini Vasan, it's a kharpar kalpa. Lagumalini Vasan acts as a rasayan. Yograj Gugul. Most of the times people, the doctors, they prescribe Yograj Gugul. But Yograj, why? What is the role of Yograj Gugul in PCOD? It is the best Vatagna drug, Vata Shamak drug, Yograj Gugul. That's why Yograj Gugul 2 TDS can be used, in the dose of 2 TDS can be used to treat the infertility, to treat the PCOD, as Vata is the Vata predominance is there. Then Kuberakshavati, Kuber Latakarans. Kuberakshavati is again important. It's a strong Aam Pachan. Aam Pachan mein Kuber Latakarans sabse shrest hai. Isme, this disorder is mainly due to the isme agni disturb ho jata hai isme. So Kuberakshavati agni deepan ke liye is very important drug. Sharapunkha Ghanavati. Sharapunkha, the role of Sharapunkha, Sharapunkha is a Bhedan. The property of Sharapunkha is, the Prabhav Sharapunkha is Bhedan. When I was studying in Poddar, my respected guide Chaudhary Madam was studying on this drug. Sharapunkha was a topic of study for the PhD. So we routinely, since then, we are routinely prescribed the Sharapunkha Ghanavati or Sharapunkha Churna. Sharapunkha Churna, if given from the fifth day of menses for the next 7 days, early morning, in the dose of 10 gram with the milk. Milk is contraindicated in PCOD, but if it is the very bitter in test, so if the Sharapunkha Churna is given in the dose of 10 gram early morning at Rasayan Kal with milk for the next 7 days, it helps for the ovulation. No need to prescribe Clomiphene citrate. It has got very good results. Or if Churna is not available or difficulty in consuming the Sharapunkha Churna, you can go for the Sharapunkha Ghanavati. Next slide, please. So this, the actions of Churna is a Shatavari. It contains the phytoestrogens, increases the levels of estrogen to regulate the menstrual cycle, beneficial effects in the menstrual irregularities, normalizing FSH and LH. Even the histopathological study revealed that it enhances the folliculogenesis and the presence of mature follicle, useful in the treatment of menstrual and uterine disorder. Basically, Shatavari is useful. It's a uterine tonic and it is routinely used in the female disorder. It acts also sedative and antispasmodic. Vijayasar, it exhibits the insulin-like activities and improves the function of pancreas. Gudmar and Vijayasar, these drugs are useful particularly for the treatment of insulin resistance. Then the Kunduru, or it is also known as the Bimbifal in the Sanskrit, Bimbifal. Regulates glucose and fat metabolism. Next slide, please. Ashoka, we already discussed that Ashoka is very useful drug. It contains the tannins and other glycosides which are useful in the dysmenorrhea and menorrhagia. It has a stimulatory effect on the ovarian tissue. It is important, which enhances the estrogen-like activity and enhances the ovulation and the repair of the endometrium. Then guduchi. Guduchi is a commonly prescribed drug which has got the anti-inflammatory, analgesic, and which regularizes the menstrual flow and useful in the management of menstrual disorder. Especially the anti-inflammatory and analgesic action is important. Then aloe vera, kumari, it improves the fertility rate and has got the anti-inflammatory activity. And trikatu, the bioavailability enhancer activity. Trikatu has got the bioavailability enhancer activity. That's why it's again an important medicine. Next slide, please. Manjista, it acts as antioxidants, blood purifier. It purifies the blood. It has got the antimicrobial activity, suggesting usefulness in the various gynecological disorders. But especially it is used for the as a rakta prasadan. Dashmool, anti-inflammatory and action and uterine tonic, useful for the menstrual disorder. Sunti again is very important drug. It's aam pachak. Sunti is the shrestha aam pachak, and it detoxifies the body. Deepana, to improve the digestive property. It normalizes the function of apana vayu. Best drug to reduce the excess fats, and it acts as a liver tonic also. Rasayan and anti-inflammatory. The main actions of sunti are ampachan and anti-inflammatory. Next slide, please. Now the Kuberaksha, Latakarans. It's the best ampachak drug and anti-flatulence. It elevates the vata dosha. It acts as a uterine stimulation, uterine cleansing action. Improves the menstrual discharge. And Hingu, the best medicine to balance the vata dosha. It relieves the flatulence. It is used in the kitchen. It's these are the spices used in the kitchen on a daily basis. Hingu relieves the flatulence, mitigates vata and kapha, antispasmodic action, anti-helminthic. The helm is chromic vigatak action iska, and the laxative also. It helps to improve the production of progesterone, which is important. Traditionally, it's been used by women to restart their periods after menstruation has stopped for some reasons. Okay, it simply increases the fertility and fecundity. Next one. Suvarnamakshik Bhasma, Rason, and Methika. Again, these three drugs are also important. Methika is fenugreek. It acts as a hypoglycemic agent. Like the metformin is given in the modern medicine. This is the Ayurvedic hypoglycemic drug. That is Methika, fenugreek. And it also reduces the cholesterol, promotes the menstrual flow. Next one. Last 2 minutes. I'll sum up in the last 2 minutes. Next slide, please, sir. These are the few formulations. Sharapunkha, I already discussed about the Sharapunkha. Then the Shatapushpa, Shatavari, or Sariva, Manjista, Tilgud, already discussed. Ashwagandha, Arjun. Arjun is helpful to minimize the risk factors, the cardiac. The patients of severe PCOD are on cardiac risk. Arjuna helps in minimizing the cardiac risk. And Hingvastak Churna is the Deepan. It is helpful for the Deepana. And Trifala and Latakarans. Next one. These are the drugs specially useful for ovulation disorders. Ashoka, Dashmool, Shatavari, aloe vera or kumari, gugula, hirabol, and the harmal. These drugs has got the, these drugs are useful in the ovulation disorders. Next slide. These are specially used for the ovulation problems caused due to PCOS, which are the Latakarans, Varuna, Kanchanar, and Gugul. These four drugs are useful in the ovulation problem, especially it is when it is caused due to PCOS. Next one. Most of the times, thyroid interferes with the it is associated with the PCOD. It interferes with the PCOD. Arogyavardhini Vati, Kanchanar Gugur, and Punarnava Gugur. These three drugs are useful in treating the patients of PCOD with thyroid disorder. The doses and other things I have not mentioned, that you can decide according to the rogi and the vyadibal and the prakruti. So I have not mentioned over here. Next slide. Drugs useful for the premature ovarian failure. Ashoka, Dashmool, Chandraprabhavati, Shatavari. No need to select all the drugs. Means you can try a single drug also. Means you can use combination or you can try a single drug also. Chandraprabhavati, Shatavari, Guduchi and Jivanti. These drugs are useful in the ovarian, premature ovarian failure. Next slide, sir. Lifestyle changes, I had already discussed about it. Next one. Yoga. I will recommend yoga over exercise because the muscular exercises increases the testosterone and the female body is not supposed to do hard work. In the, whenever patient comes to me, aapke agar koi patient hai, wo gym mein bolte ki hum gym mein ja rahe hai, to immediately stop the gym because it's a muscular activity. That is the basic, that is the major difference in yoga and gym. जिम में सिर्फ मस्कुलर एक्सरसाइज होते हैं, वो सिर्फ शाखा शाखा का शाखा पे उसका एक्शन है, लेकिन योगा ये कोस्ट पर भी इसका असर होता है. सो योगा स्पेशली इन योगा जो मार्जारासन, इसमें श्वानासन, भुजंगासन, सूर्य नमस्कार में ये 12 आसन सब कवर हो जाते हैं और शरीर में एक ऊर्जा उत्पन्न होती है. इसलिए सूर्य नमस्कार and yoga, in yoga mein agar surya namaskar specially recommended for the PCOD patient, stop the gym. Agar koi langan karta hai wo bhi upvas wagera usse vat ka aur prakop hoga, gym se bhi vat ka prakop hoga aur muscular exercises, so immediately stop the gymming activities and ask the patient to start yoga only and meditation. Why meditation? In PCOD patients, they are suffering from the stress. अगर वो किचन में है कोई पेशेंट, मैं हमेशा पूछता हूँ कि आप किचन में अगर आप प्याज कट कर रहे थे, आप तो प्याज करते कट करते टाइम पे या सब्जियां कट करते टाइम पर आपका ध्यान उधर ही रहता है कि और कुछ दूसरा आप सोचते हो, तो पेशेंट बोलते हैं कि हमारा ध्यान नहीं रहता. कभी कभी गैस चालू रहेगा तो मतलब वो उनका ध्यान नहीं रहेगा. तो मतलब जो काम कर रहे हो, इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट. व्हाई मेडिटेशन इज इम्पोर्टेंट? पीसीओडी पेशेंट को एक सूत्र मैं आपको दे रहा हूँ कि मेडिटेशन अलग से करने की जरूरत नहीं है. कि आप आराम से बैठे आंख लगा के, तो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट फॉर एनीवन एक्सेप्ट द योगीज. क्यों? क्या कुछ ना कुछ विचार मन में आता है. सो बेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ मेडिटेशन इज बीइंग प्रेजेंट इज द बेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ मेडिटेशन. एक बड़ा मंत्र आपको दे रहा हूँ कि बीइंग प्रेजेंट इन द सिचुएशन. अगर मैं लेक्चर दे रहा हूँ तो मेरा लेक्चर देने में अगर ध्यान है तो मैं प्रेजेंट हूँ सिचुएशन में. आप लेक्चर सुन रहे हो, so you should be present in the lecture. So it is a type of meditation. आप जो जो काम कर रहे हैं उस पर अगर focus कर रहे हैं आप, that is the being present is the form of meditation. और एक causes में discuss करते time पर आप जब भी when patient comes to your OPD, उसको एक सवाल जरूर पूछे कि 99% patient में स्पोर्ट्स का हिस्ट्री रहता है, मतलब वो कोई कबड्डी में रहता है, कोई खो खो में रहेगा, कोई फुटबॉल में रहेगा। मैं तो हमेशा पूछता हूँ कि आपने स्पोर्ट्स का हिस्ट्री है क्या कुछ, क्योंकि स्पोर्ट्स जो है वो एक्टिविटी एंड्रोजेंस को ये करता है। और सेकंड रहता है कि ड्यूरिंग पीरियड स्पोर्ट्स में इंडल्ज होना, नाउअडेज एज ऐड आता है कि आप ऐसे पैड्स यूज करके आप यू कैन पार्टिसिपेट इन द स्पोर्ट्स, यू कैन आप जंपिंग कर सकते हो, बट रजस वाला परिचर्या का अगर पालन नहीं करेंगे, द मेजरली रजस वाला परिचर्या का पालन न करने की वजह से द पीसीओडी लाइक डिसऑर्डर्स आर हैपनिंग। सो रजस वाला परिचर्या का पालन करना इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड सर। थैंक यू वेरी मच, लेंदी हो गया लेक्चर थोड़ा। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर लिसनिंग पेशेंटली। अगेन आई एम वेरी मच थैंकफुल टू द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स, एंड दिस सेशन इज ओपन फॉर क्वेश्चन आंसर इफ ऑर्गेनाइजर्स परमिट।
यस, थैंक यू विष्णु भावने सर। रियली आई हैव सम ओपिनियंस और मैसेज ऑन माय चैट बॉक्स दैट डू यू दैट लेक्चर वाज लिटिल बट लेंदी, but you have covered the medicine part very thoroughly and all are very thankful for you that instead of going in the pathology, because most of the practitioner knows the pathology, you have covered the medicine part, that to Ayurveda part very thoroughly and to the point. All the audience, today we have three panelists with us. They are very specialized in the today's topic. I will welcome Dr. Divya Ramgude madam. She is a HOD of D.Y. Patil School of Ayurveda. Dr. Jayashree Joshi, she is a private practitioner. She is MD and she has a related practice at Latur. And also, I have Dr. Meena Bunot madam. She is from Jalandhar. She has his own IVF center at Jalandhar, Punjab. She has done MSc Biotechnology after BMS, and from last 24 hours, she has her own IVF center at Jalandhar. I welcome all the three panelists, and the session is open for question. Those the participants or the members who want to ask a question, they can raise their hand. I will unmute them. And till that time, I request the panelists, Dr. Divya Madam, Ramgude Madam, and Dr. Joshi Madam to please give their comments. Dr. Joshi Madam. Hello.
Hi, Ji. Yes.
Hello, yes, Dr. Joshi Madam. Hello, Dr. Divya madam is there? Ramgude madam?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, madam. Your comments on today's lecture.
Okay. I already give comments. Very informative. Ayurveda and modern part thoroughly covered. If any doubts, we will discuss.
Yes,
yes.
We have...
from participant side.
You have to add anything, Dr. Bunot madam is there. Do you have to add anything?
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir. It was a very informative lecture and there was a good integration of the modern as well as the Ayurvedic approach toward PCOD. One thing I want to add that the doctor has told that he has checked one person with 70 years of age. I insist that in this age, malignancy should be ruled out instead of using any medicine, whether it's Ayurvedic or malignancy should be definitely ruled out. And secondly, the grit concentrations should be, although it is medicated, but still I feel that it should not be used in such PCOD patients, especially which are obese. And one of the person in the chat list has also mentioned that grit should not be used. And third thing is that laparoscopic drilling is not advisable these days. We should manage PCOD with the medicines plus the lifestyle changes, as laparoscopic drilling has been outdated now. And thirdly, which has not been mentioned, we should use letrozole if you want to use letrozole instead of clomiphene citrate. So that is the best drug nowadays. So these are my additions I want to add on. Otherwise, this was a very good lecture.
Thank you, madam. Great. Now I have Dr. Ghanshyam Deshmukh. He wants to ask some question. Dr. Ghanshyam, are you audible there?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
My question is, why should not use the medicated ghee? Why should not use?
This question is for whom, Ghanshyam?
Any MD gynecologist can answer.
Anyone, yes, yes.
The ma'am now just told that you should not, which ghee we should not use? Normal cow ghee or medicated ghee?
Gunot, madam.
Sir, even medicated ghee, it will not increase the metabolism. There will be the declination of the macular metabolism. So I'm not in the favor of using any sort of ghee.
What will happen, madam, if we use the medicated ghee? What will happen? What is your experience?
No, actually, my I feel that there is a lot of metabolic disorders when we use when the patient is with PCOD because of all the lifestyle changes and what they are eating. I personally feel that any person who is taking dairy products like ghee, cheese, their metabolism is very much reduced. So vasti virechan we can all use, but it should not be eating, because there is the whole metabolic cycle is not working in those patients.
Okay, thank you.
So it is not advisable to use ghee in obese patients.
Thank you, ma'am.
Your comment, Dr. Vishnu Bhavane, sir, regarding the
Girish, stop one mobile from Vishal Bhunot or ma'am.
Okay, right.
Echo is formed.
Vishnu Bhavane, sir, what's your comments on the regarding the use of ghee in your disease?
That ghee, we are not using the plain ghee. We are using the ghee, that is a siddha ghee. Medicated ghee, even in the patients of heart disease or dyslipidemia, we use the ghee, panchatikta ghrut, for the vaman or virechan in the purva karma, because it is the medicated ghee. That's why the ghrita, we can use the ghee if patient is comfortable with the this smell of the ghee, because as it's a medicated, so I feel that
yeah.
No
problem. Dr. Ghanshyam Patil, you have any question?
Sir. Hello.
If your voice is echoing.
Hello.
Dr. Ghanshyam, your voice is echoing largely there. You have some issues with your mobile.
He is using two mobiles.
Hello.
Same number.
Hello. Yes, Ghanshyam Patil.
Sir, 14 years.
You are not audible. Please, little speak near to your mobile. Dr. Praveen Jagtap is there.
Hello.
Hello. Yes.
Yes, sir. मेरा आवाज़ आ रहा
है? आ रहा है.
हाँ सर, मुझे ऐसा पूछना था कि तीन ड्रग है, सपोज एक कुक्कुट नक्की गुगुड़, कुबेराक्ष वटी और लता करंज वटी, तो इसके यूज में कुछ ऐसे स्पेसिफिक अवस्थाज है जो जिसके ऊपर कोई प्रकाश डाल सकता है कि कहाँ कहाँ पे यूज कर सकते हैं, एग्जैक्टली कुछ डिफरेंस हो सकता है उसमें?
डॉक्टर विष्णु सर.
ओके, तीनों ड्रग में से ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस अगर आपको सिलेक्ट करना है तो कौन सा करना चाहिए, ऐसे बोला ना आपने?
नहीं, उसका अवस्थानुरूप कहाँ पे यूज कर सकते हैं, कुछ है क्या डिफरेंस उसमें, मतलब तीनों ड्रग में?
लताकरण, कुक्कुट नोकी और कुबेराक्ष.
और कुबेराक्ष,
कुबेराक्ष और लताकरण सेम ही है ड्रग. लताकरण को ही कुबेराक्ष कहते हैं, तो कुबेराक्ष जो है एक स्ट्रॉन्ग पाचक ड्रग है, तो कुक्कुट नक्की से भी आई विल सजेस्ट कि जहाँ पाचन अपेक्षित है स्ट्रांग वहाँ पे आप ये यूज करो, और ये कुक्कुट ओवर द कुक्कुट नक्की।
ओके सर,
एनीवन फ्रॉम ऑडियंस वांट्स टू आस्क क्वेश्चन दे कैन रेज देयर हैंड सो आई कैन अनम्यूट देम एंड द पैनलिस्ट और द स्पीकर कैन आंसर योर क्वेश्चन।
लता करण सर उष्ण भी है तो वो देख के उस हिसाब से इस्तेमाल करना चाहिए पेशेंट को। हेलो,
हाँ बराबर प्रकृति और काल का, प्रकृति काल के हिसाब से ये आपको जजमेंट लेना पड़ेगा।
विष्णु सर,
हाँ
सम सिनेरे वेद्यस आर यूजिंग कामिनी कुलमंडलम।
कामिनी कुलमंडलम बराबर, दिस इज नॉट अ ग्रंथोक्त योग। पूना में कुछ लोग है वो ये योग यूज करते हैं, मैंने वो लेक्चर भी सुना है मैडम का। तो उनका आरोग्यवर्धिनी और कामिनी कुलमंडल के सेम कंटेंट्स यूजुअली सेम है। कुटकी का कुछ डिफरेंस है उसमें शायद, क्योंकि ये शास्त्रोक्त योग नहीं है, अनुभूत योग है, और उन्हें काफी अच्छा रिजल्ट मिला। कामिनी कुलमंडल अगर आपके पास अवेलेबल नहीं है तो आप आरोग्यवर्धिनी भी कामिनी कुलमंडल के जैसा ही रिजल्ट दे सकता है, क्योंकि जो जो ड्रग है वो वही काम करेगा। कामिनी कुलमंडल का ही मतलब अच्छा रिजल्ट देगा, लेकिन अवेलेबल नहीं है तो आरोग्यवर्धिनी वटी भी यूज हो सकता है, क्योंकि वो अनुभूत योग है।
अच्छा, आरोग्यवर्धिनी को कुमारी की भावना देके वापरते हैं कुछ लोग।
क्योंकि मैंने कामिनी कुलमंडल यूज नहीं किया है किसी पेशेंट में, लेकिन मैंने सुना है कि उसके रिजल्ट्स अच्छे हैं। एक चार पांच दिन पहले ही लेक्चर था गुना की कोई मैडम का।
सर, सम पीपल्स आर यूजिंग सहचर तेल मात्रा बस्ती फॉर पीसी वाइब्रेशन।
हाँ,
व्हाट इज द रोल?
सहचर जो है एक इट इज सहचर इज इट्स अ स्ट्रांग वात शामक ड्रग सहचर। तो सहचर तेल मात्रा बस्ती, कोई भी बस्ती या मात्रा बस्ती जो है श्रेष्ठ वात शामक है, और सहचर खुद श्रेष्ठ वात शामक है। इसलिए सहचर का अगर मात्रा बस्ती कंटिन्यूअस इज गिवन फॉर द कंटिन्यूअस थ्री साइकल्स देन इट इज वेरी मच यूजफुल एंड रूटीनली हम लोग यूज करते हैं। मतलब और तिल तेल और अदर अगर आप सहचर देंगे प्रिफरेबली तो रिजल्ट्स काफी अच्छे हैं।
निरोह बस्ती देने के बाद भी अगर ये 8 दिन का हम देते हैं और बाद में सहचर तेल का बस्ती देते हैं तो उसके भी अच्छे रिजल्ट आते हैं। और सहचर तेल का बस्ती देने के बाद 3-4 दिन के बाद पेशेंट को हो जाता है, ब्लीडिंग शुरू हो जाता है।
डॉक्टर नरेंद्र चौधरी, हेलो।
हेलो सर, मैं ये पूछना चाहता हूँ सर कि हेलो आवाज आ रही
है? आ रही है सर।
मैं पूछना चाहता हूँ सर कि आफ्टर मेडिकल से पूरी एज में आयुर्वेद की ये सब देने के बाद रेडियोलॉजिकल एविडेंस जो है पीसीओडी का वो कितने देर में क्लियर, आपके पास ऐसा कोई स्टैटिस्टिक या डाटा है कि कितने देर में क्लियर हो जाएगा और फर्टिलिटी कितने दिन में सस्टेन हो जाएगी फर्टिलिटी, ऐसा मैं पूछना चाहता हूँ अगर कोई स्टैटिस्टिकली आपके पास है।
इसका स्टैटिस्टिक्स है लेकिन ऑलरेडी अभी दो मैंने बोला कि मैं खुद 2000 पेशेंट पर ये ट्राई कर इसका कर चुका हूँ। इसका डेटा है, आपको अगर मेरा नंबर आप लिख लीजिए पर्सनली आपसे मैं वो डिस्कस कर सकता हूँ। लेकिन मेजरली इसका जो चिकित्सा सूत्र है उसका अगर पालन करेंगे, इसमें पेशेंट्स इन्वॉल्वमेंट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। हम लोग बहुत मेडिसिन दे रहे लेकिन पेशेंट इज नॉट रेडी टू इम्प्रूव द लाइफस्टाइल। आप कोई भी कितना से अच्छा ड्रग दोगे तो रिजल्ट नहीं आएंगे। और आपने जो डेटा का कहा तो वो तो मैं आप मेरा नंबर लीजिए क्योंकि अभी इट इज नॉट रेडीली अवेलेबल विथ मी बट लेकिन मैंने खुद रेगुलरली हम लोग ट्राई करते कि यूजुअली पहले साइकिल में हम लोग योग बस्ती देते बाद में मात्रा बस्ती पे शिफ्ट करते पर नस्य मतलब एचपीओ एक्सिस नस्य से बैलेंस हो जाता है। और योग बस्ती में आप योग बस्ती देते टाइम पर या योग बस्ती देते टाइम पर आप जो अनुवासन यूज करते हैं उसमें भी आप सहचर यूज कर सकते हो।
तो भी सर एवरेज ट्रीटमेंट रेजिम कितने ड्यूरेशन का रहेगा ऐसा?
सिक्स मंथ्स का मेजरली पेशेंट को मिनिमम सिक्स मंथ्स का पीरियड देने का कि आपको सिक्स मंथ्स तो भी लगेगा रिजल्ट आने के लिए, क्योंकि पीरियड तो महीने में एक ही बार आता है. मतलब यूजुअली हम लोग ये कॉमन सेंटेंस यूज करते हैं कि पीरियड तो एक महीने में एक ही बार आता है, तो एटलीस्ट सिक्स मंथ्स तो देने चाहिए आपने, सिक्स मंथ्स टू वन ईयर.
थैंक यू सर. अजय इज देयर?
गिरीश, one question is from Dr. Ghanshyam Patel. Is recurrent mouth ulcer related to PCOD?
Divya madam, is Divya madam there?
One question is there. Is recurrent mouth ulcer is related to PCOD?
Shall I answer it?
Yeah.
Our panelist is someone going to answer.
Divya madam is there?
Yes sir.
Madam, you have one question. Dr. Dhanda sir, please go.
Yeah.
Ha sir.
Is recurrent mouth ulcer related to PCOD?
Please ask. Recurrent mouth ulcer related to PCOD? इम्यूनिटी अगर कम हो जाएगी तो मतलब रसक्षय रक्तक्षय. माउथ अल्सर्स क्यों होते हैं? क्योंकि हीमोग्लोबिन कम रहेगा तो होता है जनरली, बी कॉम्प्लेक्स डेफिशिएंसी. तो अगर समझो हम, और पीसीओडी में भी क्या है, धातु अग्निमंद्य, धातु अग्निमंद्य, रस धातु अग्निमंद्य, तो इट इज को रिलेटेड विथ एक्चुअली आई थिंक. मतलब अगर इम्यूनिटी लो है तो माउथ अल्सर्स का ये रहता है, मतलब पॉसिबिलिटी रहता है. और पीसीओडी में भी धातु अग्निमंद्य, अग्निमंद्य, मेटाबॉलिक डिस्टरबेंस रहता है, इसके लिए इट इज पॉसिबल.
वन अदर क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम डॉक्टर धनंजय कुलकर्णी. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस इन क्राइटेरिया ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट इन ओबेस एंड नॉन ओबेस पीसीओएस पेशेंट्स?
एक्चुअली पीसीओडी संतर्पण जन्य है और अपतर्पण जन्य है. अपतर्पण जन्य मतलब लीन पेशेंट एंड संतर्पण जन्य मतलब ओबेस पेशेंट. तो ओबेस पेशेंट की ट्रीटमेंट दोनों का अगर समझो संप्राप्ति देखे जाएंगे, कॉजेस डिफरेंट रहेंगे, मगर संप्राप्ति में अग्निमंद्य रहता है. तो दीपन, पाचन, वातानुलोमन एंड बाद में फिर पंचकर्म और तिक्त रसों का प्रयोग. जो सर ने जो दिया है सब मेडिसिन का लिस्ट, उसमें काफी तिक्त रसात्मक द्रव्य है. तो सबसे पहले स्टार्ट ये करना है कि दीपन, पाचन, देन शमन चिकित्सा, उसके बाद फिर शोधन चिकित्सा, एंड देन वी कैन कवर दिस थिंग्स.
थैंक यू. Yeah. Ask audience, sorry, delegates or audience, if they are having any questions.
Dr. Ajay is there. So I think we can conclude today's session. Before concluding, I will request Dr. Vishnu Bhavane sir to please give a take-home message in short, and later on we will move on to the vote of thanks and we will conclude after that. Dr. Vishnu sir,
you want me to speak?
Yeah. Give a take-home message in short. That after that we will conclude.
Okay.
So your experience, first, take-home message.
Okay. So, I am very much thankful to all the organizers, Fertility Society, NEMA, MSB, and NEMA CC. Especially, I would like to convey my special thanks to Dr. Gajanan Dhadve sir, Dr. Girish Daga sir. And my take-home message would be, I already quoted it, that the best form of meditation, to be present, being present in the situation, is the best form of meditation. no need to do meditation separately. This is the take home message. And we collectively, we have to, because this disease, majorly it's a thief of womanhood. It is majorly affecting the young girls. So, and the prevalence rate is 10 is to 1, means in 10 girls or teen females, one PCOD patient is, we are finding one patient. So it's a collective responsibility of all the practitioners, students, academician, researchers, that this disease is majorly affecting the fertility. So we all need to collectively fight this disorder by just merely improving the lifestyle and the meditation. Thank you. That's all.
Great. Before moving, I am switching my mic to Dr. Gajanan sir for vote of thanks. Just I want to share tomorrow's program. Tomorrow, that is the 16th May, the topic of the webinar was tubular factor and infertility management. And the speaker will be Dr. Rajesh Utane sir. He is MS and DJ in Ayurveda science. Also, he has a PhD. So tomorrow program will be on tubular factor and infertility management. And day after tomorrow, that is on Sunday, we have one more legal webinar, that part two of our legal committee webinar. The topic will be medical certificate in medical practice. And the speaker will be Dr. Nitin Kothare sir. So these are the forthcoming two webinars. And the later in the next week, we have some proctological webinar also. So I will give mic to the Nadve sir. And I will request him to please give a brief introduction of the specialty societies which NIMA is forming. Please introduce some societies that people can get attached with such societies, and please they can make their group and communicate their individual experience in their group. I will request Dr. Gajanan Dharve sir, please.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
NIMA Central Coast separately started some societies in our specialty. Fertility Society of Indian Medicine, NIMA, then Pediatric Society of NIMA, and Proctology Society of NIMA. All these societies are working all over India for the betterment of our graduates. And today's lecture for his speaker, Dr. Bhavane sir, presented very nicely a lucid subject, a dry subject, that is PCOD, in a lucid manner. Therefore, special thanks for our delegates who are attended more than near about 300 and above for today's webinar. Thank you.
And also I am thankful to our panelists, respected Dr. Divya Madam, Dr. Joshi Madam, and Dr. Gunod Madam. And most thankful to all the participants and members who have joined our NIMA's webinar. And almost 300 people have joined in this webinar, and almost 400, 500 people are seeing on live on YouTube also. The YouTube link will be shared to you, and you can in future also you can take reference of this lecture on YouTube. I am thankful to you, and see you tomorrow with a new lecture of Dr. Rajesh Utane sir. Thank you.